picked the wrong week. Quit sniffing glue.
We don't need no education.
Well, hello and welcome back. It is the middle of October 2016. For the first time in 27 years, I am not at the State Fair this week. I can't begin to tell you how much fun that is. Big doings this week. Big doings this week. Tomorrow, this is Monday, by the way. Tomorrow, I've been promised, and I have every reason to believe, that the wall comes down, or the brick comes off of the wall in the addition. This is a day I've been waiting for since I first had the idea for this room and first started noodling together design ideas. So that's going to be fun. But we are also hip deep in Excelsior and Batplane. And Batplane's kind of stalling right now because I am, you know, doing brain work on the colors. But I am filling those busy hours with working on the painting templates for, get ready, the Excelsior! Let's have a look. You can see the Batplane taking up a large portion of the table, still sitting on its little spindly legs. But what I'm also doing is working on templates for the Excelsior. And this is the normal process. I put tape down on it. I trace out my outlines. I scan that. I work on the lines in the computer. And then I plot out the first go-round in vinyl. And then I refine the shapes. And then I go through this again as many times as it takes to get the shapes refined. And I'm pretty close on two tries. Usually the third one, the third iteration is usually the keeper. Sometimes I revise it further after that, but I think I'm pretty close. This is the second round, what you're seeing now. And basically, here's what it looks like on the plastic. Now, I don't know how clear it was last time I talked about it, but what my intention is to spray, after you prime this, spray this entire area blue, all over blue. And I've noticed on the Excelsior, more so than on the Enterprise B, because back when the Excelsior, back when they were making Search for Spock, which was the movie that the Excelsior premiered in, they weren't all, you know, everything wasn't about Aztek textures and heavily textured things. That's more of a after effect of CG modeling. And while it's true that both the Enterprise and the Reliant before it had an Aztek look to them, it wasn't all about let's make this as complicated as possible. So the blues that are used on the Excelsior are fairly flat. They're not a lot of, you know, thousands of different colors of blues that go together to make up the one blue. So that's kind of what I'm trying to emulate. I'm not going to go nuts on trying to make a million colors of blue. I think I'm just going to keep the paint areas kind of flat. But like here, this is going to be blue, and I may break it up with some highlights and some shading, but not nearly as much as maybe later ships you would see. But here's the trick. Now, see, this is the area that I'm masking off. I'm going to paint that blue, put the mask down over it to protect the blue, and then paint the grays and the whites over top of it. So, again, this is the second round. There's some refining of that shape that needs to be done. Luckily for all of us, this kit has a lot of panel lines that are recessed and makes it easier to, like, you know, once I put something down, I could, if it's too big, I could trim it off with an X-Acto and refine the shapes that way. So that's what I'm doing, and I'm on the I'm on the third iteration now. So I need to remove all of this vinyl and plot that and go from there.
Well, good morning. It's Tuesday, and hopefully this is the last time I will be seeing this particular window frame. Now, last night I went nuts and took out all of the window and the trim around it to make ready for today when they come and take the brick out from the other side. And possibly, I don't know if they're planning on cutting through today, but getting ready to do that, I wanted to make sure the windows were protected from any flying brick in case I need them. There they are on the floor. Since they are the same size as the rest of the windows in my house, I can use them as replacements should anything nasty happen. So let's take one last look at the opening, shall we? Aw, cry, cry. Well, I promised you progress pictures, and it's a little after 11 o'clock, and you can see much progress. A lot of bricks gone. Now they're going to come back with a masonry saw and saw down through the straight line there to trim out both edges and along the bottom. But the next step is to open that down to the ground. But I think what I'm going to do is rip out the framing of that window like I did on the inside. I think I'm going to do the outside just because I want to. Well, good morning. It is, let's see, I think it feels like it could be Wednesday today. Yes, it is Wednesday. Not because I declared it, but because it is. And I'm bouncing back and forth between the Batplane and the Excelsior. One neat thing I did on before I get into the Batplane was I decided to open up the shuttle bay on the Excelsior because it's got these two wonderful little shuttle bays with nice, wonderful little shuttles, which are all new. And since they went to the trouble of you know, molding those, I thought maybe I'd give it a chance to show it off. Now, I am going to be using this guy, but when you put that over top of it, you get to see inside and see the shuttles, and I think that's a nice little bit of detail that they've included, so I'm going to show it off. But today, right now, at this moment, what I'm interested in is working on the Batplane a bit, and I want to lock these engines in. Again, as I've said numerous times, too numerous to remember, that this model has the variation that will allow you to build it with the wings folded up. And when you do that, the engines pivot right here so that they go like this, so that this thruster is facing down. But when the wings are down, and this is a locked position, so I'm going to go ahead and glue that into that position. It just gives me more area to handle it. It's with all the little doors on the bottom, it becomes quite delicate despite its size. With all the little hatches that can break off on the bottom, you want to be able to have a beefier handhold on it. So this is the next step, is to go ahead and glue those guys in. Okay, I think I've got the templates worked out. So now I'm down to doing some last bits of pre-painting construction. And this is where it comes in very, very handy to have a nice piece of glass on your bench top, because you can lay these two guys flat and you'll know that they are flat and level. And then when you put this on, you can kind of level it and trowel your glue in there, and because it's a tricky, tricky joint anyway. But then you'll know that at least the tops of the engine bottoms, as you will, are parallel to each other and on the same plane. So what I'm going to do is put a bunch of glue in there and put some weight on it and glue it down like that, and then we'll be ready to do some more preliminary construction before we actually start putting this thing together and painting it. Goal for today is to get this put together and to paint the blue on the parts of the ship that need to have the blue on it. And now it is finally time to put some paint down on the Excelsior. Yes, what we are going to do is overpaint the areas that get the blue. I'm going to paint them, give them a nice coating, maybe put in a little bit of texturing on them, not too much, because the Excelsior did not have really as much elaborate Aztec-ing as the Enterprise B, as far as, you know, just going overboard with everything. So we're going to keep it simpler, make it a little bit more graphic, but what we're going to do now is put the blue on the areas that are going to get the blue, and we're going to overpaint them a little bit, and then let that coat dry, and then we're going to start working in some textures. Then what happens after that is we put the paint mask down to protect the areas that we had painted blue so that we could paint the grays and the whites over top of that. And then when we peel the masks back, the blue is still there. But it's easier to paint the blue and mask it and then paint the white than it is to paint the white and then mask all of that to paint the blue, particularly when it comes to those fine pinstripey areas. You will see what I am talking about in the due course of building this, but for right now, let's put some blue paint down. Okay, I've got the first coat of the intermediate blue. This is Tamiya intermediate blue, and it's a little too tealy for my tastes. So I'm adding a drop of, or maybe two drops of flat blue and one drop of sky blue to it to maybe punch it up a little bit. So let's put a coat of that on. Oh, and by the way, you may also notice, let me grab the part to show you, that I have blocked off this area here with a yellow template or a painting mask. And what that is protecting the darkest blue areas from the lighter blue that I'm getting ready to paint over top of it. Let me do the other one and it will be set to go. Okay, it's time to paint some accent colors. We're going to be doing accent colors on these two big blue sections, on these gray sections, and a little bit on here. Now, there is blue on this. Sorry, quit rolling around. On this blue. Now, there's blue on this bit here, but we're going to leave that. We're not going to try to put too many different shades or tones in there. But on these big sections, we will. So, what I've done is taken my good old trusty set of texture templates, and we're just going to lay this on here and shoot an accent color through it, move it around, shoot it again, and then that'll be it. Now the secret is going to be in how subtle the colors are, because I really don't want them to be that drastic. So I'm going to mix up a color that's maybe, since I added some blue to this, or some brighter blues to this last time, I may go back with just a straight intermediate blue mix to give a duller set, and then maybe a lighter tone on top of that. So it's experimenting, it's fun with color, and that's what we do. Okay, I've had my bit of fun, and now I'll show you what I've done. Didn't mean to make that rhyme. Sorry about that, folks. What I did, take one of the patented handy-dandy texture templates, laid it down on the ship. Now, this is a personal preference, and it's up to you, but no matter, it's a question of how much pressure you use. If you stick it down really well, when you spray it, your shapes will be very well defined. If you kind of hold it up or do that, then it's obviously, when you spray it, they're going to be fuzzy, and it'll give you more of an organic texture and more of a lumpy, fuzzy shapes. But if you, like I say, if you want them nice and crisp, you use the adhesive side and you stick it down to the hull, and then you just spray through it, pick it up, move it, spray it, pick it up, move it, spray it, and like that. And the color choices I have mixed up were in the Vallejo line, just a couple, three blues. You can get these same colors in Tamiya's, but I was wanting to experiment with Vallejo's. I haven't used them that much. I used this on the Nautilus and really liked it, so I wanted to try a couple more and see how well they blended and sprayed and all that. Now, on these smaller parts here, I left that the solid color. I was not going to try to implement any paneling on that, because I figured those smaller parts of the ship were probably made out of solid pieces. But here's what the belly looks like, and you can see it's, you know, from a distance, it's that overall blue, but when you get closer, you see that it's made up of plates, and that's kind of the idea. Yes, I've oversprayed. Yes, that is way too much, but what I'm going to do now, actually not right now, because right now I'm going to put a coat of clear over these to kind of lock them in, but I'm going to put the mask over top of that to protect this area and keep it looking like this, so that when I spray the grays over top of it, these will be protected. But you can see, you get, it's kind of a patchwork that is the overall blue that you're looking for, but it's a patchwork of colors. And this is the top deck, which is not done in blues, but it's done in grays, because the way the ship needs to get built, I need to go ahead and do this. So I did the same thing to give me a patchwork of grays. I'm going to spray a blending coat over top of this to kind of knock these down because I think maybe they are just a little too contrasty. So a nice coat of just a misting over that to knock it down, and then we will be spraying all of this with a clear protecting coat. And while the Excelsior bits are outside with their clear coat drying in the midday sun, it is time to turn my attentions back to the Batplane. And we're going to get a good base color on this today. Now it's got the black primer on it, but now we need to start building up color. And the most logical place to start is the Batmobile. Yes, made by the same people. And I don't just mean Mobius kits. I mean, if you are Bruce Wayne and you have all the money in the world and you've already contracted somebody or made it yourself to make this Batmobile, you are going to take that technology over into the Batplane, which would also include the materials and the color scheme and all that. I mean, you know, he's not going to paint one thing purple and the next thing green. He's going to try to keep everything in a family, in a design style. I mean, you can see the cues are there, right down to these little wings on the back and the pointy windows and all that kind of stuff. These little air intakes here, very similar to those air intakes there. So you can believe Lucius Fox or whoever is doing his R&D is using consistent materials. So the first thing we need to do is get a base color on this that looks like this. And if I remember correctly, this was gunmetal. So I'm going to start doing some gunmetal. And I think what I did was I dry brushed some either aluminum or steel over these high spots. So we're going to start doing that. So the first thing we need to do is get a base coat of gunmetal on here. And as big as this is, you might think we need a big Wagner power roller on it, but I'm going to handle it in a couple different bits. First of all, this is still not glued on because I have hopes that one day I will be getting the cockpit back from wherever its travels take it, and I will be able to put it back inside there. So the windows aren't in, the cockpit tub is not in, but I could do a remarkable amount of painting with these parts still separate. And these wings here are not glued down because I want to paint underneath them before I do glue the do gluing down. So let's take these off and warm up the old airbrush and pull out the gunmetal. Okay, I don't know how well it translates onto the camera, but this has got a nice light coating of the Tamiya gunmetal on top of everything here that you see here and that you see here. And it's going to serve as a base coat. I'm going to go in and obviously try to make some panels stand out and some other interest. They look kind of blotchy. That's intentional. I'm going to go in and, like I said, accent some stuff. But want to get a good overall tone so that I can start working on that. And I've been matching it up against the Batmobile for tone to make sure that it's of a piece that looks like a same material and made about the same time. So we're going to set this aside to dry, or actually I'm going to leave it here and go aside myself because this is huge and not easy to move around. And I will go grab some lunch and I'll be back shortly. And here we are in the midday sun drying along, and you can see I've gotten a nice little, again, not too drastic. You can see there's shading there if you look for it, but it's meant to kind of disappear into the overall tone. And once this has been good and dry, then I will mask it off, protect it, and start painting the other bits. But it looks like I've got some sanding and some puttying to do on that joint first. Well, it's Friday, and work continues on the Excelsior, and we are almost ready to start covering up all of this blue. As a matter of fact, I've done it here on the front edge of the pylons, and I will explain how I did that when it comes to doing the back edge of the pylons. But before I can cover up this blue inset ring, I need to go ahead and do the Azteking on that because it's going to be the easiest to do that now before we cover all this up than it will be after all of this has been painted and you're trying to go in there with blue. So what I've done is you need to use these wedges You can see, if I can get it under the light, focus. There you go. That's what we're putting on there. Now I'm including a separate set of these. They are in the pie wedge. There's a section you'll be able to see, but I'm including a separate set of them because it's just easier to work with them this way. And each one of these, each, like this whole thing here, each, I'm gonna zoom back out, each one of these will do two of these. You'll see positive and negative, and I'll explain that in a second. But I want to go ahead and do that and spray the lighter blue color now, and then I can cover the whole ring up before I start painting the grays and whites. And here you can see that same, that one pie wedge spread across two hull sections. And all we got to do now is repeat it the whole way around. And yeah, boy, it is not that easy. This set is not for the casual modeler. I'll go ahead and tell you that. It is a skill level 5. You will no doubt find it a lot easier to work with these if you separate the positives and negatives on the paper and kind of space them out, put them on the paper about where they belong, and then pop them down that way rather than trying to do one at a time and then move it back and forth. It's just gonna be a lot easier. First you remove the surrounding bits and then you pop out the individual Aztek pieces. And you keep going on, and the next thing you know, you are only a little bit further down when you think, boy, that's a lot of work and you've only got two more to show for it. Well, you've got 20 more or 10 more sets to go. So settle yourself in for the long run, because this is not quick work. Here we go, one half down, one half to go. Yes, this is tedious work, but the more time you spend doing it correctly and carefully, the better your overall results will be. You will not regret putting in the time once you start taking these little guys off. Well, here's the end of the work week for the inside of the addition for this week. It's Friday afternoon, and largely what you're seeing is what I've done. I only had one day out of five where we had any trained professionals coming in this week. I'm getting quite frustrated at the amount of time that's not being spent on it. But the professionals came in and took out the brick to this point that you see it. And then I'm waiting yet for another guy to come in with a masonry saw and saw straight lines and, you know, clean that up. But everything else has been to yours truly. I took down the wall board there, and there used to be a couple of planks across there that I've taken down. And getting kind of frustrated waiting for them to show up, so I've been doing it myself, which has been fairly good at exercising some demons. Nothing like a little bit of hard work with a pro bar and a pry bar and a hammer. But that's where we sit. Maybe we'll have more progress to show you next week. And of course, the hole from the inside. I will go ahead and drape that tarp back over it. I've been leaving the tarp off, but now that I'm raising dust out there, I'm trying to keep it off of the goodies in the house. So up the tarp go. Well, it only took 6 days, but it's done. No, I'm joking. It's taken a good chunk of off and on. I didn't want to do this, sit down and do it straight through, because frankly, I cherish my brain cells more than that. This is tedious work, but it's rewarding. I promise. So now this is all done. And what I need to do is spray a lighter contrasting color of blue over top of it. And then I'm going to let that dry tonight. And that's going to finish us off for the week on progress on the Excelsior. Wow, that blue is really not that bright as it looks on the camera. But I have sprayed a blue over top of all those yellow bits. And I'm going to let that dry for the rest of the evening. And this is going to bring it into the work week. I'm going to do some work on it this weekend, quite probably. And I will be documenting that for next week's report. But I think that's going to do it for this evening.
And I think that's going to do it for this week. I got a lot done on the Excelsior and not so much done on the Batplane. Got a lot of coverage done on the Batplane, but I still haven't quite noggined out the final finishes on it. But time was taken up on the Excelsior and doing some work on the addition that, frankly, wasn't being done by professionals. So, you know, you left me alone with some tools, and I just went at it. So until next week, when we will continue work on the kits and hopefully have more work done on the house, have a good week. Be good to each other. Be nice. Be kind whenever you can. And we will see you here next time.